Welcome to the Young Broken Board Podcast, episode number 31. Ooh. My name is Miguel. I am joined today by my two compatriots.
Eddie.
Yep. We're missing Kevin because he's actually out having a life, which is fine.
R.I.P. R.I.P. Yeah. Kevin. This is dedicated in his memory.
To making sure he doesn't lose another family.
Jesus Christ. Well, I'm not sure. Was that a Suicide Squad meme?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for clarifying that.
Too bad he just lost his family.
How was this week?
Pretty shitty.
I haven't
been getting sleep.
That's right, you told me.
Because it's apparent.
Yeah, me too. Kind of shitty because I was just dealing with, like, time mismanagement. I just fucked up my schedule completely. Started on Monday and just went throughout the whole week. Sorry, guys. That's why I did one video this week. So, or last week, my bad, when this video was coming
out.
Well, that sounds way more... We should maybe let you go last because that sounds way more interesting than what we have going on.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. I was just going to say...
I mean, not really because... No? Like, I'm
interested.
I guess what I just did was just I wasted my time playing Arkham Knight.
Oh, okay.
And also, on a more to make myself sound not like a complete bum, on Monday, usually on Mondays, I would film and record Jobby the Song. Mm. And I spent too long on Jobby the Song, which is what fucked up my schedule throughout the whole week.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was supposed to spend like 1 hour. I spent like three because I was just having fun testing out the mic.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
God damn it.
Well, that was this week that you were testing out the mic?
I'm constantly testing out the mic, basically. Okay. Just trying to find, you know, messing with the mixer, trying to find the right sound. And I spent too long on that and I ended up not recording audio for my review. Which is why the video that I posted last week, the War Greymon review, sounds like I don't give a fuck. Because
really
at that point,
yeah.
I didn't. I was like, I'm at the end of my rope. So I think I spent like 2 hours just bullshitting. Kind of like what we do in this podcast. Yeah. I was just treating it like a podcast. And then I cut it in parts during editing. That's why that week's video feels a bit different. And people noticed it. And they liked it.
So they liked the change?
They liked when I don't give a shit. So... I might continue that.
So low effort content is the best content, apparently?
Apparently.
Nice. I like the sound of that.
That's why my editing just consists of putting the clips together and then I export them.
in my case, I still like spend a lot of time on the post, you know, on editing, but recording was just a real like chill time for me.
So how does the mic sound to you now?
Good.
Good. Bueno. Yeah.
I think I need to mark my mixer though to kind of
That's a good idea.
Set the
That's what I do on Premiere. I have like editing notes actually.
Yeah.
Like when I position our faces when they drop down.
Ah.
Yeah. Because they need to be exact, otherwise they like one drops a little bit faster. That looks pretty funny.
How did you do that? Did you keyframe that or something?
Yeah. So I like pretty much where I want them to land.
Yeah.
I put a keyframe there and I work backwards.
There we go. Yeah. That's what I do when I keyframe shit.
Yeah. So. It's just a little bit. Because you know exactly where you want to position it at the end. Mm-hmm. So you just work.
Oh, man. I love keyframing. I don't know if you guys noticed. I love my keyframes. Yeah. even for like the littlest shit, like screen clip transitions, I would keyframe them. Mm-hmm. Like, you know. A clip bumps another clip.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a separate? Is that a like a its own tool and
in Premiere?
It's just like an
editing feature.
Yeah,
you have
like an application of a tool.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Not a tool specifically made for that, but you know you can do that.
Yeah.
Right. Editing cast.
I was gonna ask you real fast. Just a side note: your mixer, how many inputs does it have?
Two.
Two. Good to know. Good to know.
And that's why I bought it. For our purposes.
Yeah.
I'm want to get it started. But we just really need to be serious and schedule that out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, in terms of recording and uploading. So,
mm-hmm.
And if you guys don't know what we're talking about, Let's Plays.
Yeah, yeah, I forgot
potential
to,
Let's Play.
I forgot to mention that. I think it was in our gaming tops and bottoms that we haven't released yet. I wanted to ask the audience if they
the
want
viewers.
The viewers,
the revenue.
I'm just kidding. Love you. If they want to see some more gaming related content on our channel, that'd be something we can look into doing.
Mention
I mean,
it down in the comments below on this video. Even.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yes, sure. Yes, please,
because we want you to say yes.
Yeah, because I don't want.
Basically,
I don't want to just assume. Because I mean, I think we want to do it, but we want if we have an audience for it for sure.
But in a way, if we want to do something and we do something and it feels like we wanted to do it, I think it'll attract an audience.
No.
No?
We have to pander to the audience, John.
Oh, okay.
That's how we live.
Let me think of something. You guys... Okay, let me be serious with you guys. You are the best family on YouTube, and I love you guys so much.
Oh, God.
And we're... I mean, oh my God, I can't even.
We're gonna start doing Twitter reviews on YBB.
We're gonna do story time videos. Like this one guy literally raped me.
I am literally shaking right now.
Literally shaking. I don't know if you guys have heard about that whole drama between what Tana Mongoose, some story time YouTuber, and she's been having like beef with iDubbbz. That was a pretty...
Oh, I did. Yeah, well...
It was a train wreck of beautiful proportions.
I watched...
I don't know either of those people.
I watched Philip DeFranco's coverage on that. Philip the fuck ass's coverage on that.
Yeah, he did cover that.
And I don't know... He didn't refute the fact that iDubbbz, like, did kind of like as a prank.
No, you know, my thoughts on that is that in general, over like the situation, I feel that Tana is a little more in the wrong, but I don't think iDubbbz handled it perfectly.
I'm talking about the first interaction they had when.
Oh,
that was just
someone
like
someone got raped.
No,
yeah, she literally got raped. I'd be like, he grabbed her, he choked told her to say.
I'm not gonna say it on this cast.
It was like one of her like shows or something like that, right? And
one of her live shows, yeah. But he did it because she talked shit to him on Twitter.
Yeah, but what? Yeah. What a like shitty way to handle that.
That's why.
Still, like
that's why.
They were having that. She was having her live show, and yeah. At the end of the show, I'm assuming she did like a photo.
Yeah, like photo shoots.
Taking pictures. Yeah. Pictures with her fans, and then iDubbbz like just showed up and kind of like as they were taking a picture, he just screamed the N-word, and I was just like, "That's fucking. That's. I mean, that was really childish. I think.
Mm.
That's like a
Is
really.
She black?
No, she's white.
No, honestly, iDubbbz makes it a point in his response video to that is that the situation could have been easily diffused right then and there because he admits that it was really a childish, like, stupid thing to do.
Yeah.
But the way that she handled the situation was what made it into beef. She could have just brushed them off and said, like, that wasn't funny. You know, why would you say that? But instead, she makes a whole video exaggerating the situation, you know, saying shit like, oh, he chokeholded her and abused her and, like...
I mean, I guess there's...
Threatened
really,
her life.
There's really no good...
Yeah.
There's no good, like, good... And there's no protagonist in this story.
No,
they're both
definitely not.
Who has more subscribers?
Really
Tana.
I don't know. I have no
idea. Tana does.
She does?
I think so. But before this becomes the baited podcast starring Keemstar... let's move on to different topics.
What are our topics for today?
So I fucked up my beard.
Oh yeah, have you guys noticed that?
I look really. I look.
There's no beard.
I look really fat in the webcam.
Wait, in the faces that you in the faces that you put on the beginning of the video, no beard or no beard?
I don't have a beard in that picture.
Okay, so maybe you guys didn't catch that because it just the face just lines up so perfectly with the
current face. I didn't have a beard. Pretty early on in the channel.
Yeah, you didn't. I remember.
Unfortunately, yeah. I
photo doesn't.
So leave down in the comments below if you like the lack of beard. If you don't, we're just gonna glue pubes to his face.
Exactly. I need to lose weight. That's what it is. Like the beard does a really good job at hiding all my flaws.
We all need to lose weight, yeah. But some of us.
I think it was Bernie who said like he's just trying to hide his face
that
as much
he needs
as possible.
To lose weight.
Well, no, he just tries to hide his face.
He has a beard
and
glasses.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm on the same boat.
He wears a hat sometimes.
Yeah.
That's Calchop, right?
No, that's well, I mean, they're on the same company.
But like, Bernie's pretty much
the
face of Rooster
Teeth. Oh, okay, yeah. Okay. Yeah. That's funny.
I guess for topics.
Wait,
so
how did you fuck it up? Like you said, you cut one side too short.
Yeah, so I have this trimmer and I have this beard trimmer that like you
beard
pretty
eliminated.
You pretty much like you set to what I guess what I don't know
the setting
length yeah
oh the
there's
length, yeah.
Length settings
yeah
and I guess it wasn't locked to one so when I started like trimming it like went down one.
Oh.
And I started trimming and I was like fuck this side's really short and I was like oh, I just fucking
You bit off more than you can chew.
Yeah. So I was like, I just might as well commit to having no beard.
Mm. The one I use, the trimmer I use, it has those plastic things you put
on
top
of it. No, that's exactly what it was. But you have, and on mine, you have to lock it on the back.
Oh, okay.
So it stays in place. And I guess it wasn't locked. So when I was like
pushing it against my face. It like changed.
Yeah, like pushed down. I was like, fucking shit.
Even the one I use, it's too short. Like if I did it the way, I'm pressing it as much as I can against my face, my beard would be really short, like super short. So really? I still kind of have to like eyeball it, making sure I'm doing it evenly to the length I want.
Yeah.
So I don't know, like when you said like, oh, it looks all right. I'm like, all right, good. And fuck it.
Yeah, no, it looks good. It looks nice and clean. I was really, because he actually asked me, like, while he was cutting my hair. I was like, oh, do you want me to trim up and line up your beard? I was like, nah, I'm going to take care of it at home.
Is it extra?
It's extra, yeah. But they usually do a good job. The first time I actually did it, I did it at that same barbershop, and they did a pretty good job. But I've only trimmed my beard once, and it came out decent. So like, I'm gonna do it again. And I just fucked it up.
How much extra is it? Like $5?
I think so. Yeah. I think it is $5. Which is not bad. If you want it done well.
I mean, how often would you have to trim your beard? Not that often.
Not that often. Not as much. Not as often as I get my hair cut.
Oh, really? I say it's worth
well, because it has a slower growing rate.
Well, I just let my beard get out of hand more than I do my hair.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's annoying. I like barbershops though.
Yeah,
I do not.
A good atmosphere.
You don't?
No, I don't like interacting with people.
Oh, see.
Oh, okay.
I usually do.
I mean,
like,
that's understandable.
The barbershop that I've gone to, I've had the same barber for like the 3 times that I've gone there. I always get that same guy, and he just never talks. I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna watch the TV then.
Oh, that's cool. I like him.
I like having a little comment, like little like chit, like bullshit chit chat. None of it matters. Like, oh, how's your day? Oh, it's going well. Nice weather we're having. Yeah, it's a nice weather.
You like that?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know. It's just human interaction.
Such faff.
Like to each his own, but I think I might be with Eddie on this one that I prefer to just keep quiet.
Yeah.
No, yeah.
But I will tip them heavily if they are nice and you know, if they greet me properly.
Yeah.
You know.
I can't stand people who don't tip very well at barbershops.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Who don't what?
Tip very well.
You judge other people's tips?
Yeah. Well, I've only said it once, cuz the actual haircut wasn't even that expensive either, but he tipped like $2 and I was like, "Come on." Come on. Come on. You cheap fuck.
No, yeah. I was going to say that like whenever I get an Uber or a Lyft driver and they're like, they just don't talk the way. I'm like, 5-star.
The Uber driver we shared, he was really talkative.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. He was talking shit, too.
Yeah, he was.
Wait. Like, on what day? The day that...
We went to Echo Park.
Where we saw Eric Andre?
My death.
Your death, exactly. Yeah.
I didn't even know you drank that much. That
you
day.
Know what? I think what it was the fucking stout that I had at the second bar that we went to. Because it had...
I remember.
Yeah, like I think it was Beechwood's Mocha Machine or something. Mm. It had a really weird like dairy aftertaste, and that kind of lingered with me throughout the whole night. And it was really strong too. It was like 9%.
No, jeez.
So like after the cider that I had, where we saw Eric Andre, was it like some arcade? What was it called again?
Button mash.
Yeah.
You got a beer there too.
A cider.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So after that, I was just done, and then you know I threw up my guts that the following morning.
You were yelling pretty loud when we were playing Mortal Kombat. Or yeah. Street Fighter.
I do remember that.
Yeah.
That was fun.
I think most people get pretty loud when they get drunk.
Yeah.
Because I'm loud generally, so I think I get a little bit louder.
I think it's just a natural natural byproduct of having your inhibitions lowered.
Yeah.
You know, everyone has a filter, but your filters are lowered when you drink.
So there is a filter on you. It's a very light filter.
I mean, I think because of doing YouTube and like the shit that I do on my channel, I feel that my filter has gotten a little lighter.
Oh, lighter.
I used to have like a really heavy filter. Like I wouldn't be quite as talkative as I am today.
I felt like I have one or had one too on stream.
Mm.
Mainly because there was. I mean, I
aren't there like really strict rules for Twitch?
Not really.
Not really.
No.
I mean, can people report your stream?
They can, but if... I mean, it'll be like reporting a YouTube channel similar content. Oh, okay. If you,
that
it's like, oh, this guy's cussing a lot. I'm like, Twitch.
Well, I mean,
there's the
age restriction thing, right?
Oh, yeah, there is that. You can set your
channel. The Great Migs raped me. reported.
You can set your channel to be like for mature audiences and stuff. Oh, like that. I mean, obviously, okay. If you're spewing like a bunch of like racist hate speech, obviously you can get flagged for that.
Right.
But I mean, you should.
Yeah, yeah. Don't really want that content.
I wonder if there's an audience for that though.
The Twitch, they're really toxic people on Twitch.
Mm. Are there?
Yeah, and they're really toxic channels. That's kind of what their channel's based off of. Like,
you mean like political discussion?
No. I mean just talking like mad shit.
Like Leafy but streaming, I guess.
Exactly. Yeah, it's like they're
not to name them.
The audience like feed
literally the cringiest Twitch channel.
Like they just feed off like negative attitudes. I guess.
Yeah,
it's pretty bad. It's like they have like pretty at that point they have no control over their channel.
I don't want to get knee deep into YouTube drama again, but it's kind of the reason why I don't gravitate towards like commentary channels, because a lot of them do promote like negative attitudes on YouTube. Like they point out a content creator and then they trash them. I mean, as a fan of iDubbbz, I might be a hypocrite on that, but like some people who do it poorly without any effort, they're just throwing shit out there without making it funny. Mm. I've seen a few channels.
Yeah, like I mean, that's the same reason.
But a lot of them are popular, which is a shame.
It's the same reason I don't like H3H3. It's a similar content. It's like commentary. It's a
similar concept, but in my opinion, H3H3 kind of does it in a more tasteful way.
We can disagree there.
Okay.
Agree to disagree. It's kind of along the lines of almost like mob mentality.
Yeah.
It's definitely. Like, let's attack this one person.
Yeah.
In the comments, and sometimes actually, like, if they're attacking a certain YouTuber, they can go to their channel like, oh, Leafy said you're dumb.
Yeah.
You smell.
But I guess for in that case, it's like Leafy got a taste of his own medicine.
Yeah. He attacked the wrong person.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
So you guys seen anything?
I watched Hail Caesar.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah. It's okay.
I keep confusing Hail Caesar with Oh Brother, Where Art Thou. They're two.
They're both Coen brothers.
Yeah, they're both Coen. Mm. I just think they have similar logos, probably. That's why I'm getting them confused.
Yeah, it was definitely a movie.
Wow, really?
I didn't enjoy it that much. I was like, okay, this is fine. There was like a lot of characters that didn't really like. Like ScarJo's character wasn't like very impactful.
Pretty big ensemble.
Oh, Hell Caesar. That's the like a more recent one.
Yeah, it came out last year.
Was that their last movie?
Their most recent one?
Yeah,
I think so.
So after No Country for Old Men.
Mm-hmm.
They had some in between. Yeah, actually.
Oh, okay.
They had Inside Llewyn Davis.
Ewan.
Those are kind of filmmakers that I do want to follow, because from what I seen in Old Country for Old Men, I really did like their style.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know. I might want to watch a lot more of their. Yeah,
Fargo's really good.
Is Great Lebowski them too?
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah,
That movie is also like that.
That was a weird movie.
It was a weird movie.
It's really popular.
It really goes off the rails towards the end.
Mm. Yeah, that's a movie that I do want to watch because apparently it's really well loved. Kind of a cult hit.
Raising Arizona is them too, right?
I have no idea. Okay. I don't know what
that's the movie that Nicolas Cage won an Oscar for.
I
watched this, pretty well deserved.
Wow. Oh, speaking of the Coen brothers, I just thought of this really like funny ass story about I guess this is kind of like Hollywood legend. I don't know if it actually happened, but this whole situation about why Bill Murray took the role of Garfield in the live action version. He thought the script was written by the Coen brothers, but it was a different guy named Coen. But by that point that he realized, he was already locked into a contract.
How shitty must that writer feel? Like, Bill Murray's like, oh, you're a fake Coen.
Basically. Oh, but God. But Bill Murray did it.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. Wasn't there like sequels to it too?
Did he do the
just
sequels?
One sequel?
Oh, okay.
Just
did he do that sequel though?
He did. I think it was locked into a two movie
I think it was part of the contract, yeah.
I mean, it works for the character. He just sounds like he doesn't give a fuck.
Yeah.
That movie sucks. Did it make it? It did. That's why he got a sequel.
Who's his human or whatever?
His human.
I don't know.
Some white dude.
No, that's Alvin. Alvin the Chipmunks. It was Jason Lee. Jason Lee, Neil Patrick Harris. These are the people who have the distinction of being in one of those shitty live action CGI animation hybrid movies.
Neil Patrick Harris, is he in Smurfs?
It's the Smurfs.
He's in Trolls.
Trolls? Justin Timberlake and Anna Kendrick.
No, but like
that's a fully animated film. Though.
Oh, it's a fully animated. Trolls is fully animated?
Yeah.
That was like the Smurfs.
No, thankfully.
Is it Breckenmeyer?
Huh?
Or is that?
Are you talking about? Are you looking up the Garfield cast? Yeah. The heart pounding questions.
Why is he? Billing? Yeah. Why is not? Why is Bill Murray not top?
Maybe he asked for it.
Jennifer Love Hewitt's in this movie.
She is, and wow. She looks good in it.
I love Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Her
face looks a bit odd. Just saying.
Yeah, but you don't look at her face.
Oh. That's fine.
I didn't mean that.
Just tits on.
Cut that out.
Face just looks really sharp.
You don't like that?
No. I like it.
Me too.
A little scary.
She looks like a character from Batman the Animated Series.
Like a triangle face. It's funny.
I know I watched something this... Or I didn't watch... There was a trailer for something.
Did you watch anything, Charlie? Have you watched anything?
No, but I... Like I said, mentioned earlier, I am playing Arkham Knight.
You are?
Yeah.
Video games.
Video games.
Oh, you wanted to mention something about that.
About, right? Arkham Knight?
Yeah. Oh,
About what, like, Barbara Gordon.
She's our favorite.
I think she is our favorite. She's our favorite meme.
Barbara.
It's just sex. Get on it.
Doesn't have to mean anything.
Oh, that actually reminds me of something else too, yeah. But go ahead.
Oh, well, I'm just saying, she can't catch a fucking break. Apparently, all Barbara Gordon exists is just to give grief to our main characters. Like, do shit to her, and it gives more dramatic conflict for main characters.
That's the, what is it, the trope? Like, just using the...
Women in fridges. Yeah, I think that's what they call it, yeah. Because, you know, have you heard of this, Miguel? Well, like, named after, like, a famous comic book storyline where I think one of the Green Lanterns comes home to find his girlfriend stuffed in the fridge. And basically, what people criticize that for is that, that character existed only to cause grief for Green Lantern.
Mm-hmm.
And Barbara, it almost feels like recently she's been that character.
I think recently, because she played.
She was Batgirl before.
Exactly, she was Batgirl.
Yeah, but now recently she just can't catch a fucking break. Arkham Knight... Fucking terrible shit happens.
Bullet right to the spine.
Yeah.
And Arkham Knight, she's already Oracle, right?
She's already Oracle. She has no legs. Leave her alone.
Well, she has legs. It just happens.
This happens after she becomes disabled.
What? Yeah.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah.
Like she gets,
so she gets no, but she gets more grief after that.
Yeah, like Arkham Knight, who I'm pretty sure is Jason Todd. Spoiler, like, you know, spoilers for a few year old game, but
yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's Jason Todd. He fucking abducts Barbara from her wheelchair and tosses her over his shoulder and...
like Donkey Kong?
Yeah, like Donkey Kong. That's right. And she,
what? Fist or what?
No. Okay, spoiler warning for Arkham Knight. She fucking dies.
Oh, she does?
She dies in Arkham
Knight? Right in front of you.
In Arkham Knight?
Yeah. It's fucked up. Like the
Oh, that's the podcast.
Like our favorite meme.
She
just fucking died.
Is it because of the Joker stuff?
No, it's the whole setup was one of the I think the most emotional parts of the game is that, you know, for the first half of the game you're trying to find her because she's gotten kidnapped by the Arkham Knight, and until the Scarecrow like announces on the Gotham speakers, he's like, "Oh, I have Barbara at a safe house in Chinatown." And you go over there, she's behind a glass wall. You can't really do anything in there. And then Scarecrow's like, you know, like, it's a prank. You're not never gonna save her. He pumps gas into the room, and she sees Batman as a monster. And there's a gun on the table. And Scarecrow's like, "If you want to get out of here, you either gotta shoot yourself, you either gotta shoot Batman or yourself." And then she, right in front of you.
Wait, if she saw Batman as a monster, why didn't she shoot the monster?
No, she was doing that at first, but then I don't know. Like, she just decided that this was the best way to go.
Wait, so how far in the game are you?
My save says 59%. So.
Oh, okay.
But that's probably because I've...
You're doing
I've been doing all
side
the,
stuff,
the side
yeah.
quests, too. So.
Yeah, the main game is never, like, the whole full 100%.
Yeah. But yeah, that scene was fucking heartbreaking. Because up until that point, like, Kevin Conroy's performance as Batman is really stoic. But at that point, he breaks down. Like, Kevin Conroy nailed the acting there because he sounds really, like, distraught. You know, like,
Barbara!
Yeah, exactly. He says Barbara in such a, that's like, funny. Heartbreaking tone.
Yeah.
Like, Barbara, no.
Does he actually cry a little bit?
You could kind of hear in his voice that he's shaking a little bit, but then he kind of has to pick himself back up because he tells Alfred on the comm, and then Alfred's like, we shouldn't let this death go to waste. The people Gotham need you. Get out there. And then you do another cycle.
He's like, it doesn't mean anything.
That's what I kind of love.
It's just a death. It doesn't have to mean anything.
That's the funny thing about games. That, like, you kind of have... You don't have to it's not a streamlined story. You can kind of just go back.
Yeah, you could kind of do your own thing. That's funny too, because the Joker hallucination in that game kind of he kind of points attention to it. Because after one of the story missions, you see him at the corner. He's like, "Oh, what are we gonna do next, Bats? Are you gonna do a Riddler challenge, or are you gonna drive around in the Batmobile for a while?" He kind of like makes fun of the player for going out of
The Fallout 4 is funny that way, because you're rescuing your son. But like, hold on, let me explore for a couple weeks first.
Yeah, you gotta be prepared to go into the, what the fuck they call it, the radioactive wasteland.
Oh, like the boonies.
Yeah. That's my justification. It's like, I'm not ready yet.
Exactly.
I've been ready for a long time.
Yeah. For me, my justification for my mind was like, Batman has a lot of shit on his plate. He can't just be focused on one thing. Like, even Alfred says that there's still open cases that you've yet to solve. There's a murderer going around, Two-Face is robbing banks, the Riddler's kidnapped Catwoman. You gotta deal with all that shit.
I feel in that case, it's much more justified when, like, in Fallout, I think all you need is, like, you don't even need you don't need power armor even. You just need a radiation suit.
You get a power armor in the first, like, as soon as you get out.
Oh, that too. But I have like 7 sets of power armor.
Exactly.
You're just fucking about.
Yeah. It's like that when I think about it, it's just like you really should go save your son.
I mean, he's been all right for the past 10 years. What's I guess another, so. Like, yeah. Few months.
There is a part in Batman where I felt like that, because there's a side quest where Riddler has left a bunch of riddles in Gotham, and you could solve them if you want. You don't have to, but you get like unlockables. And right in the on top of the GCPD, there's like a riddle up there that you have to solve. Like, the answer is the bat signal. You got to find the bat signal and scan it. But you can hear like surveillance from around the city. Like, there's a bank getting robbed at like this street, and it's like, hold on, I got to solve this riddle.
With like those you couldn't actually go to like little things like that where you hear something over the police.
Yeah, you can.
Oh, you can?
Yeah, there's some like robberies in progress that you could stop.
But they're robbing empty banks, aren't they?
No, the banks are full. It's just that everyone evacuated, they just left everything.
But the police are still around?
Like, the police are there, but they don't do anything gameplay wise. They're just there for like to
I mean,
dress
they don't
the set.
They didn't really do anything in the comics either. That's why
exactly,
Batman is a thing.
Yeah, so it's accurate.
Yeah.
What I do like about the game, too, is that you can actually go inside the GCPD and see all the inmates that you've caught.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
So right now, you know, I have Two-Face and Professor Pig in one cell.
They're in the same cell?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. I mean, they're like, weaponless, so.
Do they interact with each other?
Not that I know of.
But
they probably will, though. But, yeah, and Poison Ivy's in her own cell. And
yeah, I was going to say.
I've got the Mad Hatter in
another. They have the facilities to contain all the villains?
Yeah, because I guess in this point of the story, Arkham Asylum's just gone. So, yeah, they're just containing all the villains in this one spot. And soon I will catch Firefly, because he's a fucking arsonist.
Are the sequels, like, story-wise, are they linear?
What do you mean?
Like, do they all, are they in sequential order?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, they are.
Asylum leads into City, and City leads into Arkham Knight.
That's not like Arkham Knight's like a prequel or anything like
no,
that?
No, no. Arkham Knight is the...
Oh,
Origins is a prequel.
Yeah.
And Arkham Knight is the finale. I mean, Barbara's dead.
Barbara!
Yeah. I think after, you know, what they did in Arkham City, Rocksteady just felt like, yeah, we can do whatever now.
Yeah.
We killed the Joker. We can kill Barbara.
Do you think they're going to keep making Batman games?
Rocksteady? They did say that Arkham Knight would be their last one.
The last one?
Oh, yeah.
WB probably wants to keep making it because they're making
money. Definitely. I mean, their movies are gonna soon start failing.
Oh, God.
But
it's hard to let go of a franchise, like established ones.
Yeah.
Sequels always usually do better than a brand new IP. It's funny, the Origins is the only one that wasn't made by Rocksteady.
That's right. And according to reviews, they say it's the weakest one.
Yeah, makes sense.
But I've heard that it's all right. That's Troy Baker's debut as the Joker.
Oh, really?
No.
Yeah.
He does a good Mark Hamill.
He'd never done Joker before?
Mm-mm. Until Arkham Origins, and he's fucking great.
That's crazy.
Like, we've heard his performance.
Yeah.
You know, the Assault on Arkham movie.
Yeah,
that's
pretty... The fact that it's Troy Baker is pretty insane. So
Troy Baker.
I was looking.
He's in Arkham Knight.
I was reading a lot of stuff
on
Two-Face.
I was reading a lot of stuff on Bioshock Infinite, and I think he voices Booker Duet.
Oh.
Yeah.
Does Booker talk that much?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
That's a game I want to play.
Booker Catch.
I want to play the BioShock game.
Oh, they're so good.
You can skip
you
this.
You haven't played them, huh?
No.
Not even the first one?
No.
Oh, good.
So I'm definitely.
Really?
I played like an hour or two and I got frustrated and I stopped playing.
Would you have frustrated? Are you playing at the hardest difficulty?
It was in high school, I think.
Maybe. Wow, you go back and play that. Yeah, played on PC.
It's pretty good, dude. Like the
on Xbox.
You know, ever since
Jesus. Stop it.
Ever since the PC, just this new world has opened up.
You definitely should. I really recommend playing the BioShock series. Yeah. BioShock 2, you can skip over. It's, I mean, okay. If you really want to play
BioShock 2, that's the one where you play as an enemy, right?
You play as a big daddy.
Big daddy.
Ah, okay. Yeah. But BioShock Infinite. Is that that's a good one?
I really like that one. I actually think that,
would
one, that might
be my
favorite one.
Would I be able to skip to BioShock Infinite?
Yeah, BioShock Infinite kind of just
because like when time. I saw the, I remember that's a game that I was following even before.
Booker Catch.
Yeah, even before I like had the system to play it, I just thought it looked fantastic.
It's a really good, like nice looking game.
I like the concept too, like you know, America in the clouds.
Yeah, yeah. Columbia.
Yeah.
Racist America.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that concept. It's really, like this offshoot of America. This is
it's like the South just went into the South.
Yeah, exactly. Because it takes place in like 19. I think it takes place earlier than BioShock 1, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not sure.
That reminds me, like I want to clarify something about Fallout because I'm not familiar with the lore. Like, is the premise that the world ended in nuclear fallout like a long time ago? Is it an alternate history kind of thing?
I think it's a few hundred years.
Yeah, well, because the
Because like from the soundtrack, it's all like old pop songs.
So. But
it's
but
like
the, well,
time froze pretty much.
Kind of. Yeah,
because well, when they're in the few before the Fallout happens, I think they're still pretty far in the future. Like 2050 something, for example.
Oh, okay.
Like 2060 something, but for some reason they're still kind of stuck around that aesthetic.
Oh, so it's kind of like
when the bombs dropped, they were like in this weird 1950s
mm-hmm.
retro future.
Yeah.
So like, you know, they had a robot assistant and they had like
they never really discovered the processor or like processing power. They're really more
so it is like an alternate history.
Yeah, they skewed more towards atomic. Yeah,
that's cool.
Energy,
power.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ah, I see. And that's probably
that's why everyone has cancer.
Exactly. Yeah. The
that's
ghouls.
Why ghouls are a thing.
Yeah.
That's fucking awesome.
Fallout is a really good game. You should pick it up too. Yeah. Mm.
So many games.
Start
that
with like
I
Fallout 3, New Vegas, and then Fallout 4.
I would say even like try to. I want to try to play the first ones.
No.
They're just so vastly different.
Mm.
They are. Yeah.
It's like gameplay wise.
It's like trying to play Grand Theft Auto 1, where it's like top down.
Yeah, but even those are a little bit more similar to kind of how you would play GTA because the very first GTA is very much like free roaming and you
kind
it's
a very
more.
Early PC kind of
yeah
game. It's like isometric view
top
view and then I wasn't because they for a long time ago I think they released
free,
it for free yeah BioShock 1 and 2 I think it was due to a lawsuit
not BioShock
Fallout sorry and I tried playing I was like this is
different.
You know what old game I do want to try to play after playing Doom? I want to try playing the first one. Because the game still holds up, right?
Yeah.
I enjoy it. The fucking music.
I love the theme, and I'm proud to say it. I learned how to play like the basic melody on piano. It's really hard.
Yeah.
Oh man. Doom is fucking phenomenal. I've actually gone back and unlocked some of the classic maps.
Mm.
They're just, it's so well hidden that when you find it, it's like, yes.
Wait, so like it actually takes you back to the old like style graphics and stuff like that too?
Just the map looks classic. You're modern, you're and the still, monsters are modern.
They did that in Wolfenstein as well.
Oh, but like the...
But the
environment.
Yeah. The environment.
The enemies are all old too. I don't know. I mean, that's how it was in Wolfenstein.
Oh, in Doom, the enemies are still.
That's
new.
Weird.
It is kind of weird. But yeah, the map is like ripped directly from the first games.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because the Nazis in Wolfenstein, they're like 2D.
Well, because I don't think there's like the glory kill kind of mechanic.
That's true. Yeah.
No, that's
why it'd be kind of weird to like. I mean, that'd be cool if they made separate animations transition into that.
That'd be pretty
ripping
cool.
Ripping in half an old enemy.
That would be fucking awesome.
Fucking pixels coming out.
Yeah, now that you say that, it's kind of a missed opportunity, honestly, to have that because that would have been fucking awesome. But nah, you get the normal enemy types in the classic maps, which is kind of weird looking, but it's pretty fun regardless. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And also, they take away all your weapons, so it's hard.
Oh really?
Yeah, the classic maps are challenging.
Wait, what do you have
then? You just have the basic pistol.
You can't pick up any new weapons?
If the level has it, you can.
Oh, okay.
Because the second classic level you unlock, there's a chainsaw. So. So, okay. Yeah. Oh, man. Shotgun. You should play Doom, Eddie.
I played the multiplayer beta.
That's not what the game is.
I mean, I really enjoyed that.
Oh, okay. Really, a lot of people didn't, really? From what I've heard.
I thought it was funny.
I haven't tried the multiplayer yet.
It was fast-paced. It was
I don't think I'm ever going to touch the multiplayer.
The game really does feel like it's built directly for single player. It just feels right, you know. Mm. I can't imagine that gameplay with maybe I can.
No, yeah, you definitely. I mean, because it's fast paced. Yeah, multiplayer will be fast paced too. But it's like
I was getting pretty good at it too.
I have my set core of multiplayer games that I only play, just Overwatch and League of Legends.
Oh,
both cancerous games.
I don't mind Overwatch, but League, man,
I'm still playing that.
Is Overwatch cancerous to you, Miguel?
Sometimes, because your team, like, because you have, I think it's six players. I think it's 6v6, if I'm not mistaken. And you have to choose like an efficient team comp.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're attacking, you shouldn't have three snipers, and like a Genji.
So just really like unbalanced teams.
Yeah, well, it's just because people want to play whatever they want. I mean, more power to them. But it's like,
I want to be Tracer,
exactly,
because she's gay. Yeah.
it's just frustrating when you're trying to win.
Yeah.
Who's her partner?
Some random girl that Blizzard created.
Huh? Widowmaker.
Yeah, that's what, Miguel, was that your ship?
Yeah. Oh, dude, I ship that super hard.
So how do you feel about Blizzard revealing that she's with some random girl that no one knows?
I mean, that's fine. They can still... I mean, I'd like to think they had a
past.
They're
still fan art.
Yeah.
Princess Bubblegum and Marceline. They had a past.
Yeah, that's actually implied in Adventure Time.
Oh.
Yeah, that's actually like
lesbian a lesbian in a cartoon?
Oh, dude, Steven Universe?
Unchristian.
That's like gay the show, man.
Oh, that's a bunch of like... Yeah, it's
a bunch of donuts bumping.
technically, they don't have genders. Shut up, they're gay. Yeah.
And women.
And I love it.
Because all like the gem, they're called gems.
They're
right?
Gems, yeah. They're like an all female right? Race. Yeah. Yeah.
Gross.
Gross. They bump rocks.
Exactly.
They grind them together.
Yeah. And like the characters can like they can perform fusion, and they treat fusion as like a metaphor for
sex.
Yeah. Mm. And there's that one point when like another character's like what, they fuse, like that's weird. She starts doing this. It's just a really like
she was a human though.
No, she was a gem that didn't share the Earth gem's values. They're kind of doing a political thing there where, like, the homeworld gems from their planet don't approve of fusion.
Did that series end already?
No, it's ongoing, but it's almost over, I think.
Wait, fusion? What purpose does fusion serve?
Like, they're more powerful.
They're
Dragon Ball Z, dude.
Yeah. They're more powerful, but in Steven Universe, they add an emotional element to it where it's like, oh, they, like, you have to get along. Like really well to fuse.
How come the homeworld doesn't approve of it?
Because they don't approve of different gems fusing. Like in homeworld, they strictly say, "Oh, it's for power." But if there's an emotional connection to it, it's disgusting. only gems of the same type can fuse, that's not funny. Different types. So they're
all. That's funny.
You get it.
Oh, that's fucking funny.
It's like gay sex is legal, but like
yeah,
that's funny.
Yeah. So like gems of different types are not allowed to fuse in homeworld.
It's pretty hilarious.
Actual type genders?
No, like... different gems, like there's pearl, amethyst, garnet. There's different pearls. Yeah. That's kind of a plot twist they reveal in the middle of the season where it's like, you're not the only pearl? It's like, yeah. I'm like that's a breed of gem instead of a unique name.
Under fucking stud.
Yeah. That's funny. Good show. Nice lore, actually. Really well developed lore. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think Adventure Time's coming to an end, so I think they announced
That still wasn't done?
No.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think the next season might be the last one. Or the one after.
I kind of have to get back into
it. Does that have a streamlined story?
Some episodes. Some episodes build to a streamlined story, but most of Adventure Time is kind of like these offshoots.
Standalone.
Yeah.
Okay. But, well, I mean, there's still like in certain episodes that seem disconnected, you'll see kind of like nods to other things that have
happened. Right. You're right.
So okay. It's kind of like this overall.
It's just like a
like in giant. The first few episodes, you can see the snail, and then snail turns out to be an important plot point.
Yeah.
That's
so stuff like that. Mm. It's really well thought out. That's what I really appreciate about that show. And it's super easy to binge. It's
dude,
like 11 minutes each.
Rebecca Sugar is a great creator.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She doesn't do anything with them anymore, really. Like
for Adventure Time. For Adventure Time, she wrote some of my favorites.
Mm.
Yeah.
I mean, now since she's doing Steven Universe.
Yeah.
She's just
she's just doing Steven Universe right now. Yeah.
Because I think they've brought her like one or two episodes
to do something. Back to for Adventure Time, they brought her back as a voice. For the to write that song and the you remember that Marceline like four-parter event thing?
Yeah.
She was Marceline's mom, and she sang, you know, everything stays. Yeah, that's like the, you know, little reference to Rebecca, little homage.
Speaking of animation,
speaking of gay cartoons,
particularly Cartoon Network animation.
Oh, gotta get back. Back to the past.
They released a trailer for Samurai Jack.
Samurai Jack is back. I'm so excited.
I know you haven't. Are you familiar at all with the series?
No.
Like at all? Like you haven't seen? No. Wow. Well, you know what? When I went out with Omar and Oscar on Friday, we were talking about that, and I told them that I'm gonna make a list of episodes for you guys to watch, like the plot relevant ones, so you could catch up.
Is there that many?
Yeah. There's a lot of plot relevant episodes.
I meant like how many episodes?
It's a long ass show, but a lot of them are standalone. So you don't have to watch all of them to get the story, but there are specific ones that, you know, are overarching, and you know. Episodes that you had to watch to understand this new season. So I'm gonna create a list and I'm gonna fucking give it to you guys and you're gonna watch them.
That's it's really fine. Good.
Wait, is it on Netflix or anything?
I don't think so.
Nah. It probably was, but they took it down because I remember Powerpuff Girls was on there and Courage and all those Cartoon Network shows. But
I feel like they'll probably be a deal somewhere where it's like
you it's okay. I'll find a website. I'll go digging.
That was a great show. That,
like, I thought it had a short run. That's why I'm surprised.
It got cut off, but it had a long
did they actually give it a finale?
No. And that's why they're doing this miniseries to end it.
That's what kind of like makes me sad is that it's only a miniseries. It's like a limited run.
Maybe if it does well enough, they might continue.
It seems like how they're talking about
it's like this is a definite end for this. Mm-hmm. Hopefully they do like a style, like, cause I really like I fell in love with the animation when I first came out. I just really like the samurai traveling the different timelines. It was really, it's really cool. And he also visits like different universes too, right? There's like a universe
I think it's just that the world is just so varied that each location that he visits is like a new world.
Because I think there was like a movie that pretty much happens like right when he gets transferred from Japan, he goes to this world where like they're talking dogs. it's really funny.
Because
I think I'm pretty sure that was a movie.
That was the first episode.
Oh, was
that
was it? The pilot. Okay.
I think he the first time he travels into the future, they're dogs. Yeah. They're talking dogs.
Wait, so he's Asian, right?
Yeah, he's Japanese.
What the fuck is his name? Jack.
It's not. Oh. Jack is an alias.
Oh.
Yeah. Like they say that in the first episode. We don't know his real name.
Who did he come up with the alias?
No, some future guy just called him Jack as kind of like slang word, and then he just took on the name.
Mm-hmm.
So
it's really good. There's like a training montage when he's young.
That's the first one.
Yeah.
When he's a little kid. The Batman story where he travels the world after his parents.
It's really good.
They don't die, but they get enslaved.
There's also I remember there being like a Scottish character.
The Scotsman.
Yeah.
Gandhi Tartakovsky. He said that he's coming back.
Oh, yes!
Yeah.
Okay.
He confirmed that he's coming back.
That was a great fucking series.
Wait, so how does he... Because I saw in the trailer, and apparently you guys clarified that like he goes to different time eras. And like, so he uses different weapons too, right?
In this new miniseries, he's at a point where he's lost his way and he's lost his sword. So I think in those 50 years since since we last saw him, he lost his sword. He lost his will to fight. So he gave up his honor.
Which is why
he just started using fucking guns.
Which is why it's so much edgier.
Yeah.
Like it's actual blood.
Yeah, because when I started seeing that, I'm like, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah. So like seeing Jack with a gun is kind of a special thing. It's like
it's
I haven't seen
it. It's very jarring.
That, so yeah.
It's never happened before.
He has a long beard too.
Yeah. Kind of like the Kratos thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like seeing Batman with a gun.
So wait, so
it's that kind of honorable character with a gun.
So in the show, like this new series that's coming up, it's been 50 years.
Yeah,
has passed in the plot.
And yet I do not age.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't know what that's about. I'm curious.
I'm really excited for it.
Yeah.
I think it airs March 11th. I think it's
March 11th.
When it starts, check that out.
Mark your calendars.
On Cartoon Network.
Toonami.
Tsunami.
I'm excited how they're gonna how Aku. I'm excited how Aku's gonna sound because you know that voice actor died, and like from the laugh that I heard in the trailer, sounds good. Because Mako, you've heard of Mako, right? Maku Iwamatsu. He was Uncle Iroh from Avatar.
Oh shit! Really?
Yeah. And he died during the production of Avatar, but he was Aku before. So yeah, hopefully they get a good replacement.
Hopefully. They haven't named who the replacement is?
No, they haven't. But all Genndy Tartakovsky said was that they got a good replacement. They got a guy that can do a pretty good imitation, but it's not exact. But nothing's got to match up to the original.
Yeah,
guy.
Yeah.
Because his voice is so distinct.
Yeah.
What a great villain. I like Aku.
Shape-shifting. What do they call him?
Shape-shifting master of darkness. Yeah.
So is he human?
He's an ancient evil. And there's a whole, like, a three-parter that details his origin. That's gonna be on my list of necessary episodes, because that's a really good, really dark, like one of the darkest ones, because it just shows that this guy is just pure evil. He's you can't sympathize with him. He's literally like a cosmic representation of evil.
So his only motivation is to take over the world, right?
Yeah.
And to cause
suffering, yeah.
And Jack's only motivation is to stop him?
Mm-hmm. Basically. And the sword is important because it's the only thing that can hurt Aku.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Which is what gives Aku a reason to send out henchmen. Yeah.
Which is really funny because the sword,
it just looks like a sword.
Yeah. It
just and looks I kind of like that. It's just kind of a simple sword.
Yeah, like you wouldn't look at it, but you wouldn't know by just looking at the
sword. How do you get the sword?
The gods forged it.
For him?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, they actually gave it to his dad first, and I think the dad gave it to him. Because I remember they said that in the origin episode of Aku. It's called The Origin of Evil. That's what the episode's called, I remember.
How ominous.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I'm definitely going to work on that list for you guys.
It'll be nice. Good.
Yeah.
That should be the first series we do for like
a consistent... Like a review?
A consistent episode-to-episode review.
Oh, you mean the new one?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. Like every weekend we have to watch the episodes and then...
I need to start watching. When is this? Oh, you said March 11th.
March 11th.
Yeah. All right. Well, I have a month to catch up.
Yeah.
All right.
We'll have to watch out for that if you are a fan of
Samurai Jack.
On that note, we're gonna wrap up the podcast.
All right.
I would like to thank you, fine people, for joining us.
Yes.
As always, if you guys liked and enjoyed the podcast, don't forget to share with your friends and like and comment. And subscribe if you haven't already. As always, don't forget to follow our social media. Links are in the description down below. My Twitter is twitter.com/thegreatmigs.
Dropping the honk.
Eddie still has not made a Twitter page because he's a little slut.
Kevin. <He's the
only laughs> don't drag him into this.
But on that note, we will catch you guys on the next video. Watch out.
Bye.
Nice.